Members, the next question, the next item of business is an urgent question. And I call Douglas Lumsden.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what discussions it has had with the administrators of Stuart Milne Group following the news that the firm, which employs over 200 people, has been placed into administration.
Cabinet Secretary Neil Gray.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I thank Douglas Lumsden for securing this important question. I know that there is considerable interest from colleagues in the North East and across Scotland in this matter. I was very sorry to hear that Stuart Milne Group had ceased trading after 49 years. Our thoughts are with the affected employees, their families, at this very difficult time. I met with the administrators at Tenio this morning. I made clear to them that I want to see every possible support to be offered to affected staff, contractors, suppliers and home buyers. The people affected by this announcement are, of course, our immediate priority, and the Scottish Government is providing support through our initiative for responding to redundancy situations, the Partnership Action for Continuing Employment, PACE, and through providing skills development and employment support, PACE aims to minimise the time individuals affected by redundancy are out of work. The administrators have confirmed that they're working closely with PACE to provide those being made redundant with the relevant information.
Douglas Lumsden.
Can I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that answer? And I'm pleased to hear that the Scottish Government are taking this matter so seriously. This is dreadful news for the 217 direct employees of Stuart Milne Group, but there will also be serious concerns for all those connected to the supply chain, including contractors and self-employed tradespeople. So can the Cabinet Secretary confirm if there will also be help available to those people who are not directly employed but could now find themselves facing the prospect of losing their livelihoods due to the collapse of Stuart Milne Group?
Cabinet Secretary.
Thank you. I thank Douglas Lumsden for that. We understand that approaches have been received from potential recruiters already for those employees that have lost their jobs or who are at risk of losing their jobs. So PACE has asked the administrators to distribute opportunity information to the affected employees. Douglas Lumsden will be aware that in terms of the redundancy payments process, that is a matter for the redundancy payments service and the insolvency service. So I'm going to be writing today to Kevin Hollenrake, who is the responsible minister, asking them to look as sympathetically as possible to the very clear point that Douglas Lumsden has raised, which is about the impact that this will have on self-employed subcontractors, that I understand is going to be a very difficult process for, and I'm asking them to look on this favourably.
Douglas Lumsden.
Cabinet Secretary, another group of people I'd like to highlight and who will also be concerned at this development will be the customers of Stuart Milne Group, either those who have placed a deposit and are awaiting their keys, and also homeowners who have moved in and may have remedial work outstanding. Some owners will also have concerns that paths and roads that were due for adoption by local authorities have not yet been completed, so will be unsure on where that burden may fall. Now, I presume that the administrator, Tenio, will be the first point of contact, but is there any further advice the Cabinet Secretary can give for those living in that, you know, almost like building sites, and for those people who have saved up for a deposit and will now see their life savings at risk?
Cabinet Secretary.
Yes, this was an area that I raised with Tenio in the conversations that I had this morning. Douglas Lumsden will understand that we're coming at this within a 24-hour period, as are Tenio, so some of this is going to be information that is moving, and from that regard I'm happy to make sure that as the situation develops I provide as much information as possible, and colleagues across the Chamber who I understand will be interested in this are as well briefed as possible as the situation develops. My understanding is that Tenio are in discussions with NHBC and others around ensuring the situation that he fairly raises around the very difficult situation that people will be finding themselves in some cases in limbo, can be resolved. That will be a challenge, obviously, depending on the circumstances. But as soon as I have more information, as soon as the administrators have more information, I will do everything I can to make sure that colleagues are kept up to date.
Kevin Stewart.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Stuart Milne Group has been a significant employer and a significant home builder in Aberdeen in the North East for nearly 50 years, and its loss will have a significant impact on the communities that I and others represent. I'm very pleased to hear the Cabinet Secretary that he has already been in touch with the administrators, and SNP parliamentary colleagues and I have already written to them too. And I'm pleased to hear that some moves have been made to garner the facts around about what will happen, not only to employees, but also to those who have invested in homes. I would appreciate continued updates on this, but I wonder if the Cabinet Secretary could also look to ensure that NHBC guarantees stand for those that are currently in Stuart Milne homes. And I wonder if an extra effort could be made to find jobs for any apprentices that are currently working with the Stuart Milne Group.
Cabinet Secretary.
I thank Kevin Stewart for his question and also the correspondence that he and colleagues sent to me on this matter last night, in the interest that, as I say, colleagues across the chamber have taken in this matter, because obviously that Stuart Milne was based in Aberdeen, but the repercussions of this will be felt across Scotland, given their interests across Scotland. Kevin Stewart raises two very important issues, one around NHBC, my understanding, and their guarantees. What my understanding is, Tenio are in discussions with NHBC around the practicalities of that and how that can be further communicated. And as soon as I have further information to that regard, I will make sure that Kevin Stewart and colleagues are kept up to date. And secondly, in terms of the employment prospects in general, but also in particular for apprentices, I think Kevin Stewart makes a very fair point. I would imagine that these will be skills that will be in high demand, regardless of where they are in the country. And we will certainly continue to do all we can through PACE to ensure that employment opportunities are furthered as quickly as possible.
Daniel Johnson.
Since 2007, Scotland's average annual rate of housing completion has been almost 5,000 lower than the decade prior. So it's been reassuring to hear the answers about the tragic loss of jobs following this closure, but we must also raise concerns about housing capacity altogether. So can I ask, how many uncompleted planning consents did Stuart Milne hold? How many houses are currently mid-construction and remain uncompleted? And given the factors behind this closure are not unique, what dialogue and actions is the Scottish Government taking to ensure that we support other house builders who may be under financial issues?
Cabinet Secretary.
I thank Daniel Johnson for those questions. As I outlined in my last answer to Douglas Lumsden, this is we're still within 24 hours of Tenio taking on the administration of Stuart Milne Homes. And so both ourselves and Tenio are trying to ensure we get the full facts of the situation as quickly as possible. But some of the questions, I hope Daniel Johnson will forgive me, we will need some time to ensure we get. But those are questions that we have asked. Those are areas that we're looking to make sure we get further information on, and will be of particular interest to the administration process, because obviously that will be part of the marketing of any assets that may well be available going forward. And there will obviously be interest, I hope, in ensuring some of those sites can be taken forward by other parties, but that is for obviously the administration process going forward. Like Douglas Lumsden, like Kevin Stewart, I offer to Daniel Johnson further briefing as it becomes available.
Willie Rennie.
The combination of the Liz Truss budget, but also the massive cuts to the social housing programme, is partly responsible for what we've seen today, because it's a symptom of a housing sector in crisis. So last month, the government rejected the plea for it to declare a housing emergency. Does this not indicate that the government was wrong last month and should now change its mind?
I'm really sorry, genuinely, with all due respect to Willie Rennie, that he chose to politicise this matter at this stage, not least because Stuart Milne themselves said, as they went through the sales process, that the issue was to do with the wider UK housing market. Of course, we will do all that we can in order to ensure that we continue to invest in house building in Scotland, understanding the critical role that it plays, not just for the economy, but also as our social infrastructure. And we'll continue to do all we can in the face of a declining capital budget from the UK government to ensure that we can respond as best we can and most effectively that we can.